Well, Cohen's apartment and office, quote, stormtroopers. What is the long-term effect of these attacks on institutions? Joining us now is Valerie Jarrett. She is a former senior advisor to President Obama and former chair of the White House Council of Women and Girls. She will be headlining the United States of Women Summit tomorrow. Valerie, great to see you.
Thank you, Allison. It's a pleasure to be with you. We're so excited about the summit this weekend in LA.
I'm going to ask you about that in 1 second, but the breaking news that we just had moments ago were the new job numbers, the lowest in anybody's memory, 3.9% unemployment rate. It's been 15 months of Donald Trump's presidency. Do you give him credit for that?
Look, I think we have to look at it over a longer horizon than that. If you think about what the economy was like when President Obama took office, and we were losing 750,000 jobs a month, and under his watch, the unemployment rate dropped in half. And it's encouraging to see that we're continuing to make progress. We want to see wages go up, and I think that's an important focus, and I was glad to see you talk about that, too. So for the workers out there who are back to work today, I think it's very encouraging.
Okay, so before we get to what we're seeing this week from the White House between Rudy Giuliani and the president and Sarah Sanders, et cetera, I do want to talk about what you're doing tomorrow, and that's headlining this the United States of Women Summit. What is your message to women at this moment? I mean, particularly this Me Too moment and everything else that's happening.
Well, Allison, what we're seeing all across the country is an enormous amount of energy and passion. And our goal for the summit is to help turn that into action. You're right. You mentioned Me Too and Time's Up. We have the young students from Parkland. We have the Advocates for Dreamers. We have so many young people and women in particular who are running for office. According to the Center for American Politics, Women in Politics, over 500 women now want to run for Congress and countless others at other offices. And so what we really want to do is to give women the toolkit that they need to empower them to be forces for good and to fight for equity in their own communities. And we're going to put the spotlight on what is working. And so much is working. There are so many extraordinary women who are fighting on behalf of equity every single day. And let's share that wealth and encourage others to do the same.
I know that you're speaking on a panel about the path for women in politics, and it's fascinating to hear the spike of interest of women who are engaged now. Do you think that in this climate, with Donald Trump as president, the path for women has gotten easier or harder?
Look, it's always hard in politics. It's a tough sport, and I have enjoyed spending half of my career in public service, but running for office is very difficult. But then there are groups like Run for Something, run by a young woman named Amanda Lippman, and she's helping people run for office, matching funds, giving them the tools that they need to understand how to do it. And as I travel around the country, what I've heard is people who now understand, as citizens, we have to all engage. That's good news.
So, Valerie, when you watch what's happened, let's just say this week, okay, coming out of the White House, with Rudy Giuliani changing the narrative, saying that President Trump did actually reimburse Michael Cohen, his longtime fixer, for this hush money to Stormy Daniels, and everything else that's happened this week, what goes through your head?
Well, it's impossible to keep up with all the twists and turns. And I guess what I would say to you is this, Allison, and Chris Cuomo mentioned it at the top of the hour, credibility. And for the president that I had the pleasure of serving, President Obama, there was just nothing more important to him than his credibility, his honesty, his directness, and his transparency with you and the press, and of course, the American people, and his own team. And he spent a lot of time and energy and focus on you. And not on himself, and thinking about what could we do to make our country strong, vibrant, grow our economy, make sure everybody gets a fair shot. And as a result of doing that in his first term, he was reelected for a second term. And so that's the basis of comparison I have.
But when you hear people like Rudy Giuliani calling the agents who went into Michael Cohen's apartment and office stormtroopers, and all of the things that the president has said about the witch hunt of Robert Mueller's investigation, which the president calls it. Do you think this is a moment in time that will pass, or do you worry that there's some sort of lasting damage to institutions?
I have a lot of confidence in the strength and resiliency of our democracy, and I think that for those who are out there who are frustrated, they should think about what President Obama said when he left office, which is the most important office is that of citizen. And we all have the opportunity, with midterm elections coming, to get out and vote, to make our voices heard, to encourage people who we have confidence in to run for office. I mean, one terrific person, Stacey Abrams, is running for governor down in Georgia. She's terrific. My former staff member, Buffy Hicks is running for, Buffy Wicks is running for assembly out in California. There are countless women around the country and men for whom we should support, who share our values. And so I don't think that we should give up on our democracy. It has withstood a lot of stress tests in the past, and I am confident that we will come out stronger if people get out and let their voices be heard. And that's a big part of tomorrow, is to help people understand how they can make an impact in their own communities, how they can be forces for good.
Former senior advisor to President Obama, Valerie Jarrett, thanks so much. Always great to get
your
perspective on all of this.
Thank you, Allison.
Chris.
So are you one of us who has their name mangled on a regular basis because it's ethnic or just hard to say? The Deputy Attorney General.